This podcast features adults using adult language. You have been warned.
Once again, the time has come for four heroes to straddle the throbbing heart of danger.
Previously on Acquisitions Incorporated. In Shadowfell Keep, Omen, Binwin, and Jim confronted a whale death cult.
Tonight you're all gonna blow my hole.
Wait, what? Oh, Orcus. Sorry.
What did he roll? What did he roll?
He rolled a one.
Son of a What in the is happening?
With a new Eladrin intern, the party took on a necromancer, but Omen critched the bed.
You, Jerry! You!
Yes.
Oh my and god, you're horrible at this game!
That's I'm gonna okay. roll it
Divine
again.
Divine guidance. Bad guys go first.
Oh my Christ! Jerry! Jerry! What the Punch him in the hole!
Yeah, it's not a great roll.
Get your out! Get your out, and you punch him in it! What the is wrong with you?
Then, in Amber Shard Manor, Aofel split the party. And yes, it was Aofel who split the party, not Binwin. Listen back to it. It's all recorded. My friend Scott's a real gentleman. He wouldn't do that to anybody.
I have something to say real quick. I just want to take a moment. Binwin cannot die. I have built many products around him.
Oh.
So we need to make sure.
But the gang went to hell and back to save their high elf friend.
You also see bubbling up are these sort of belching gouts of acid that kind of drip.
Oh. PTSD.
Finally, at his peepaw's last will and testament, the party beat off hordes of beef men.
These creatures are reconstituted from beef.
Yes.
Are they undead?
Yes.
I'm gonna f*** them up the ass.
And took control of the Dark Magic Estate, which basically became a TARDIS.
Steering it, it's going here, there, and everywhere. Where it's going to land, we'll just have to find out next time.
Ladies and gentlemen, next time is now. Please welcome to this plane of existence, Acquisitions Incorporated! Please welcome to this plane of existence, Acquisitions Incorporated! And now, your Dungeon Master, Chris Perkins!
Adventurers. I am Dungeon Master. Your guide to the world of Dungeons and Dragons. Shall we have a seat?
Actually, Uni's going to be running the game tonight.
Yeah. That's awesome.
cool.
There's a lot of mist up here. I can't see anything.
How do you guys always, all the time, do this?
Mine's not made of yarn.
Yeah, mine actually grows out of my face.
Okay. Yeah.
It's cute.
You all have your characters.
Do we? No.
In the Darkmagic estate, there is this gigantic crystal ball that Jim Darkmagic is using to propel the entire mansion through space, time, and dimension.
And I've only had like one beer, so.
Is this crystal ball bigger on the inside than the outside? It just sounds familiar, is why I ask.
Meanwhile, the rest of you keep goading him to go faster and faster.
Jim hears that a lot.
And then suddenly there is this ear-splitting sound like a tree snapping. Just this big...
Do we see a tree?
You do not see a tree, okay. But...
Are you trying to park it with the brake on again?
But the floor beneath you trembles and shudders, and suddenly the entire house lurches, and the crystal ball comes rolling out of its fitting, nearly crushing you to death.
But
you get out of the way, and suddenly the house begins to disintegrate around you until it splits in two. And you see the back half of the house just fall away into oblivion. And you just hold on for dear lives to anything, any railing, any bookshelf.
My bedroom in the back half?
Or? Your bedroom was in the back half.
Sorry about where you grew up, Jim. I love you.
And as you hold on for dear life and the remnants of the house go hurtling into who knows where, you hit something really, really hard and black out.
Oh.
Oh. It's like rush week.
And I'd like you all to make constitution saves.
Constitution.
So add your constitution modifier to your die roll.
No Ooh. Problem.
Oh, by the way, we're playing D&D Next today.
I rolled 17,000.
How did you do, Jim?
I also rolled a 17.
That's fucked up.
I rolled a 16 plus 1.
You rolled, actually, add your modifier.
Oh, yeah, but I rolled a 17. I just think that there's, like, some Scientology shit going on. But it's 17, 18, 19. Did you see me do the math?
No, 19.
19.
13,
18, 19.
Oh, then? No, in D&D Next, is it good to have a
low
number?
Oh, my God. Hold on, I got to tweet that.
I've never played... This
is that a
before.
One?
It's yeah. a one.
Are you fucking
what?
Serious?
But I don't.
It's your first roll of the night.
Well, it's the number.
Hey,
of
you
the...
know what? There's something for you in the back of the house. Nope.
It's my first roll, so a one. If we can
the
get.
The game hasn't even started yet.
Even the Dungeon Master is against you.
Is he dead?
No, he's not dead. He's just really, really unconscious.
Good.
Possibly for the rest of the show.
We'll see you in sixth edition.
If any of you want to play D&D Next, by the way, you can just by going to dndnext.com on our website. Playtest, check it out. Binwin.
Yes.
You feel groggy, but you start to awaken. There's a horrible stench, and you realize Omen's feet are somewhere near your face.
I'm busy. I got shit to do. I can't wash every part.
But here's the bad news. As you try to move, you think you're tied down, like face down to some sort of stone slab or something.
What? We're in my mom and dad's basement, guys.
Key party at the Darkmagic estate.
Yeah.
I, as a dwarf, don't I know what direction I'm facing, though?
Oh.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, you are facing north.
How does that help us?
Yeah, take that one to the bank, Binwin. That's great info.
That is some useful information.
At least I'll know what star I was facing. Nice. Lost my second virginity.
Because your arms and legs are sort of tied down.
Great.
You're not sure where your weapon went.
No!
Ooh.
Seamus!
But then, as you sort of look around, you realize a couple things. You hear the crackling of flames.
A warm hearth, perhaps?
Hmm.
Yeah. Odds are good.
Yeah. Or a hot poker heating up. I mean, yeah. Hearth too, but yeah. Possibly a hot poker.
And you
poker.
Hear the breathing of your companions lying beside you.
Oh, thank God, they're here to witness this.
Jim and Eofel, you sort of wake up at the same time about a minute later. You're next to each other, tied down. Jim, your face is pressed down into cold stone, and you just sense it's something evil about this stone you're lying on.
Okay. It's a bad stone.
Bad stone.
It's a bad
Got
stone.
It.
Eofel, you're actually looking up at...
That's novel.
Yeah, but there's a hood over your head.
Oh, good.
I'm sorry, a what?
A hood.
Oh.
Oh, boy.
And Omen is snoring unconscious beside you.
Is it possible for me to face step out of my bonds?
Ooh.
If you can see where you're going.
Oh. Can I see AFL?
Yes, you can.
And I can see that he's got a hood on him.
Yes, and your arms
reason.
And legs are tied down to what appears to be some sort of altar.
How close is he to me?
Who?
Eofel.
He is one omen away from you.
Shit.
So we're each on our own individual stone altar.
Custom you're, slabs.
You're like fish okay. or weenies laid out on a barbecue.
Should I? So I have a feeling that it's evil. If I detect magic, would that give me any more of a...
Yeah.
An idea about what this altar might mm-hmm. be used for?
About
yeah.
How evil, like 1 to 10?
So you're able just to concentrate on the okay. altar, and you feel that horrible, horrible sacrifices have been made here over countless aeons.
That could be good. can I see my bindings?
Yes.
What are they made of?
They are made out of sinew.
And snakes.
You mean like muscle?
Mm-hmm. What? This is not my parents' basement.
May I try to break the bond with my
You sure can try.
Strength?
Just make a strength check.
Oh!
He's the opposite of you!
He really is!
That's also true in real life. I am a dumb shit compared to you. So with my modifier to 24.
Okay. Would you like to free your arms or your legs first?
Well, I'll free my arms because then I can use my arms to free my legs.
All right. The sinews snap as you free yourself.
Yeah.
While that's going on, and you're doing your detect magic, Eofel,
yes.
You hear a soft voice say, Zutalo, what do we have here?
No!
We're in France.
Where's the voice coming from in relation to
what the evil altar wasn't a clue?
Where's the voice coming from in relation to where we are?
Right behind your head.
Well, I should be able to see somebody then, right?
Yeah, when you sort of look over, you see a figure in the shadows hidden behind the altar. Her skin is her skin is the color of polished obsidian, and her hair is shock white.
Ooh. She's,
and she says...
Yeah. Go on. What does she say?
Mm-mm.
Je m'appelle Daniel. A partir le château Rousseau.
Do I know her? There's a good chance.
You have never met her before.
Ooh.
But okay. As you start to look around, your eyes adjust, and you begin to see more and more of your surroundings.
Oh, shit.
Oh, wow!
You guys, I went here in sixth grade.
What?
Do you want flame?
Weak flame. Aww. I'm just gonna stand here for the rest of the night and play with the flame.
Take it.
Did you roll to power the
flame?
There
must be a crosswind.
Yeah. That's right. At least tip it back.
It's not a performance issue.
Ha-ha! No, right, it's good. No, I like it. No, it's good.
It'll
Did
get
you
better.
Try turning it off and back on again?
Now I got your dudes here. Let me put them on the altar. You guys have a conversation or something. I'll be right there.
So there seems to be chairs for watching something.
I wonder if we can go sit in them. That would be awesome. I mean, like, there's something good's going to happen here.
All right.
It's going to be a show.
So we've got Aelfel lying on the altar.
Oh, we're up there.
Yikes.
We got Jim Magic, Jim Darkmagic on the altar. We've
What's
got
going on there?
Nothing.
Nothing at all.
And we got, there you guys are.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Tight fit.
Yes.
Just let it happen.
He can't let
That's
it happen.
That's what she said.
Sorry.
Here is the drop.
There we go. There it goes.
Never mind. Ooh, no,
all right. So
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Oh. No, it's cool.
All right.
Am I awake?
You're not awake, Omen.
Okay,
you are unconscious.
That's great. So I can see this woman, though, and I don't know her, and that scares me.
She said that we're in the house of Rousseau?
You're not sure.
She was speaking drow.
I don't know, it sounded
like
French.
No, she was speaking French.
Sounded very Frenchy to me.
Okay, so I say, hey, you untie me, ma'am? Miss?
She says, I would be very glad to help you.
Oh, thanks. See, all you have to do is ask, guys. It's not as bad as you think. I'm sure there's all a misunderstanding.
Yeah, yeah.
As long as you promise that when I do, you will help me with something.
Yeah, absolutely.
Voulez-vous coucher? Mais oui.
And she says, it is just a small thing, a trifle, no?
Well, I wouldn't say that, but...
I just got it.
Oh, okay.
I just got it.
But we must hurry before the others show up.
Whatever you need. I mean, we'll take
Is
care of it.
Is there another room you guys can go to, or?
You might learn something.
I might learn something? A new skill.
Omen, you begin to come too.
Good. Don't screw this up, man. I got a good thing going with this lady in the white hair.
Don't cock block the wizard.
And you're already free by this time.
Yeah.
So you can actually stand if you want to.
Can I hide that I'm free? Because I
might
want a cold clock.
Yeah.
Well, let's see where it goes.
First. Make
Might want a cold clocker, though. Yeah?
Just make a charisma check, or if you have the bluff skill, you can add that.
I don't have the bluff skill.
I didn't think so.
Unless by bluff you mean killer.
You're full of charisma.
Holy mother shit, fuck!
Another one?
He rolled another 20.
She thinks you're dead.
nailed that shit.
Nailed that shit.
So I just very suavely just go,
When you sort of open one eye to keep an eye on what's going on, you see your weapons and gear and stuff has all been basically thrown into the middle of the room.
Seamus.
So it's just lying in a pile in the middle of the room.
No problem.
Like whoever found you amid the wreckage of the estate just sort of took all your stuff off and threw it there.
Armor too, or?
Actually, you're wearing your armor.
Sweet.
Okay. They were a little scared to take off your armor.
So clearly we're dealing with people of above average intelligence. I say, good lady, would you remove my hood?
She says, of course, and she will remove it. And when she sees you, she goes, an elf.
And then so now I speak to her in Elvish. What is it you wish us to do?
She says, I came here to steal the, what is the word? Les yeux mal.
I'm sorry, the les yeux mal?
yes, the eyes. The eyes of the statue.
Oh.
Oh.
We can help you with that. We don't have to tie us up.
She says, but first we must deal with the others. They will be here any moment.
All right.
Okay.
Now it's time to spring to action.
You can see that she has, the only weapons she's got are two hand crossbows, basically holstered to her side.
No
That's
problem.
Pretty cool.
I'm a relatively wise fellow.
Okay.
What do we roll to sense motive in D&D next, which I understand is joinable in the playtest by visiting the website and signing up.
Why, you would make a wisdom check.
11, 13
okay.
is the total that I gain. Plus, whatever bonuses I get for shilling. Mm. Shilling bonus.
Yeah,
that's got to be plus two.
You know, is easily at least plus two. Yep. Yeah.
And you're trying to gauge what? That she's
I'm just trying to gauge her trustworthiness and whether or not she is, if she is genuinely looking for our help to get that thing, or if it is all a ruse.
A ruse?
A ruse. A clever ruse.
this is not my dog.
You believe that she is being sincere.
Oh.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that she actually believes that she doesn't think she can get the eyes by herself. And she begins to untie you all. By this time, I'd like everybody to make a perception check, or in this case, a wisdom check, if you have any special perceptive abilities.
Just, go all the way over
shit.
There. That's fine.
I have keen senses. Will that help me on my wisdom check?
Yes, you can roll twice and take the higher result.
Perfect. I Jerry Holkins'd.
So did I.
So did I.
Well, okay, it's vital to note that Jerry Holkins did not Jerry Holkins. On this particular,
I rolled a one.
I also rolled a one.
Yeah.
What? We're all gonna die.
22.
All right. Omen.
22.
You see something moving across the ceiling.
Nah.
It looks like a shadowy giant spider.
Fuck. There's a really big spider, you guys.
Nope.
When you look up, spider, get your shit. There's a really huge spider up there.
The rest of you look up and you just see some old kind of iron crow cages dangling from the ceiling that haven't seen
use. Are we talking like paper towel size spider or vacuum cleaner size spider?
More like pony size spider.
All right.
Can we actually see the spider that he claims is up there?
No.
It's real.
Guys,
it looks like
he
the shadow
hit his head when he fell down. I think he's full of shit.
No, I'm dying.
Omen, you're not feeling well.
Get your shit.
I'm diving for my shit.
There's a spider issue.
All right.
I will holster my wands. I pick them up.
Okay, so all of you hop off the altar. Go down and get your stuff.
Too soon. Too soon, yeah.
Too soon. You monster.
There's always one.
As you hop down, the drow woman sort of pokes her head up behind the altar and says, "Mon Dieu, no!"
What?
No, and
what?
As you hop on the floor, you feel it kind of give a little and then begin to sink.
Oh. Sorry about that one. You guys didn't have to follow me down here. All acid. Yes. 100% acid.
It's probably 300 squares of acid.
I just wondered if I could ask you a couple of questions is all. And talk to you about a few things. I'd like you all to meet my uni wife.
No, it's easily 300 squares of acid.
Yeah.
We know you're all jealous. So as the floor begins to sink into a gigantic...
We teleport off to the side,
Olympic-sized pool of acid.
At least it's heated, guys.
The good news is, it doesn't fall right away. It sort of sinks down.
Did you like
so
that? Did that get you?
Yeah, good.
You can all make dexterity saves.
Oh, I'm really good at that. Come on.
Why?
I'm so scared.
That's pretty good.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no! Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, no.
How did you do, Jim?
Jim got a 9.
How did you do, Omen? How did you do, Omen?
How does a 4 treat you?
How about you, Benwin?
I mean, I got a 16. I'm going to be fine.
Al?
Not a great
role. We're not
role.
Friends anymore, are we?
I hate you so much.
Does he? Does he have a plus?
Maybe
plus
you have.
I rolled twice as well as I did the last time I rolled.
Awesome.
Which side would you like to swim to, Ben?
I rolled a 2.
Swim to?
I mean, walk to.
Well, let's have a conversation with this woman up here. I'm not happy with her.
All right, you're able. She says, "I tried to warn you."
Yeah. Not really that
yeah,
much.
Really, that wasn't as it was less remember warning that part. As much as it was sexily talking.
Can I make an action? We're not in like.
Right now, I'd like you all to dissolve into acid.
All right, but before that, can I?
Really, once wasn't enough for you.
The Binwin product empire survives another day.
All right. Those of you who are in the acid take 10 points of damage.
Oh, my God.
What the shit?
I only have 21.
Well, now you have 11.
All right.
Binwin, you're fine.
I rolled a scream. No!
Let us roll initiative.
No problem.
First turn.
You add your dexterity mod.
I'll add dex.
How'd you do, Al? I mean, AOFL.
Okay, first of all, Let's clear something up.
Mm-hmm.
His name is Aofel!
Right.
My bad, my bad.
And I rolled a 6 plus 3. 9.
Okay, 9. How'd you do, Benjamin?
14.
And this dice
14.
Is going to the fuck off bag.
How about you, Omen?
You're looking at a 3.
A 3?
I also got a 9.
Oh, okay.
It's never bad when the Dungeon Master goes, a 3? 3, what?
Yeah.
He's trying
hey,
to kill
hey,
us, and even
your
he's
beard
disappointed.
Back on.
I cannot wear the beard.
Put your beard back on.
I'm glad
people,
I was born a girl, and I don't have a beard.
The people have paid good money to see you in a beard.
All right. But I beg you to let me leave the helmet off.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's okay.
It's very hot.
Because Faelauer insisted it be real. Great if we're actually attacked. I grant you.
All right, now all right, Benwin.
You're welcome.
Yes! Oh, where did the bitch go? Where is she?
While you were adjusting your beard.
Nah.
She's been nothing but nice,
she,
to be
she
fair.
Had a higher initiative than you, and when you sort of bared down on her threateningly,
yeah,
she started to scamper and crawl her way up the statue to get out of your reach, and she did really well on her strength check.
Okay, so all right, very good.
So she just scampers up there like a little spider.
She's fitting to get these
Wait.
Bad
she
eyes.
She scampers up there like a little spider is what you said.
I did. Do you have a problem with that?
No, I was just making a note that you could have chosen any way that she scampered, but you chose to say that she scampered like a spider. She has a sort of drow-like look about her. Mm-hmm. You mentioned something about Omen seeing a spider in the ceiling, and if I may engage in a bit of metagaming, when I was at Gen Con a few weeks ago, I saw a giant spider queen in the Wizards of the Coast booth. I'm just saying that you chose a word very suspiciously, sir.
You take another 2 points of acid damage.
God damn it!
But it's your turn, Benwin.
All right,
I'll be
so
good.
I'm assuming that what I see is actually what's here.
Yes.
So there's literally nothing I can
I don't
use.
Have another diorama behind
no,
me.
No, no, no. what I'm saying is I see in this diorama mm-hmm. nothing I could use to try to fish my friends out of the acid.
You do have your adventurer's kit.
My adventurer's kit?
10-foot pole, 10-foot pole.
Yeah.
What will help this situation?
10-foot pole.
My flint. No. Is there a 10-foot pole in the adventurer's kit?
No. There's no telescoping pole in the...
Everybody has a 10-foot pole, it's D&D.
Hey, look.
Hey, Benwin, this is your adventurer's kit. There can be anything you All want right. in there.
Ooh, acid-proof a raft.
No.
That would be good. That's a good idea.
Right? That's a good thing. That's what I carry everywhere with me.
Yeah.
Can never be too safe.
I pull out the 10-foot rope,
mm-hmm.
and I tie to it, and you can confirm what's at the end of
that.
Yeah,
crowbar.
Crowbar. You never know when you need a crowbar.
Okay.
And I toss it to AFL.
Wait a minute. You're throwing a crowbar at AFL?
How many points of damage do I take, Chris?
Let me roll.
Sure.
Because it might hit him. I'm not going to lie to you.
Just make a dexterity check.
You got it.
Oh, look who suddenly decides to roll in the single digits.
Just don't worry, my dex modifier is +1.
Oh, good.
So I rolled a 6.
Awesome. All right, so you feebly toss this thing into the pool. The crowbar goes into the acid. The rope end goes into the acid, and they just sort of dissolve away.
Even the crowbar?
Well, it's lying at the bottom of the acid pool being chewed on.
Oh, God. All right.
Would you like to move at all, or are you happy where you are?
No.
Thanks.
I can't save these guys.
The drow says...
Hey, way to give it the old college try, though. I'm done.
What do you want?
to save me.
I don't cast a levitation spell.
All right.
In the group. I hit things. The drow says, the acid.
We don't have time for this. They're going to be here any moment.
What the fuck? Thank you. It's like my wife is here. No, wow. Boo. It's just a joke.
All right, you're next.
I'm going to face step the fuck right out of this acid.
All right. At the start of your turn, you take another 4 points of damage, and then you are out.
Great.
Where would you like to face step two?
Put me up there next to Binwin.
Friend.
Maybe a little further away from the acid.
Like there?
A little further away from the acid.
There?
That's good.
Awesome.
Well, maybe a little, just back up against there. And then behind the sconce. Yeah, that's good. I'm there. I'm good.
Jim, you got another 4 points of damage coming your way.
Do I take it right now?
You do. But then you get to act.
Oh, good. 7 health. Rad. Now, do I still have access to my adventurer's kit, or has it dissolved? Did I have the presence of mind to...
You have all your stuff.
Okay.
It's over your head right now.
Then a length of rope begins to snake its way out of my backpack, up above my head about 6 feet or so, and then it disappears.
All right.
And I begin slowly hauling myself up, mm-hmm. and then I vanish. And then that my hand comes out of nothing and goes... and then just kind of comes back in.
All right. So Jim disappears into his rope trick extra dimensional space, leaving...
Hey, there's room for like 6 guys in here. Or girls. I mean... I'm saying if you want to climb up my rope... Yeah, I've got a futon in here.
It's Omen. I'm your superior, so it's not entirely appropriate. But in this case, I seize his rope mightily. And climb right into his hole.
Shag carpet.
Now, as I understand it,
waterbed.
As I understand it,
fire going.
I can. Is that what it's like?
Black, yeah. Black light posters.
Yeah.
Barry White.
On.
As I understand it, I can channel divinity. That is to say, use the power of my goddess, mm-hmm. And do my action for the round. That's mm-hmm. correct, right?
That is correct.
I'm gonna use my channel divinity to heal James.
Thank you.
Dark magic.
Oh. Like, who the fuck is James?
How much?
Okay, but one thing I forgot was as you were pulling yourself out, the acid was eating away at your shins and boots, and you took another 4 points of
that's
damage.
That's a classic scenario.
Yep. All right, and you apply some healing love to...
I have the healer's touch, so my healing effects are always maxed. You grab 17 points.
Nice.
Wow, that takes me back up. I mix you a mojito.
Incredible.
From my bar.
You're what?
I have a small bar. It's not a big bar. It's a little wet bar, but yeah.
You got the whole thing decked in SkyMall.
Yeah.
In every corner are those little stuffed, weird, creepy kid things like this.
You got it's all SkyMall stuff. Yeah. You have that spider vacuum.
I do. You just suck them up. You don't even have to touch them.
Get that.
As Omen disappears up into Jim's hole.
That was a free one. That was
like
a freebie.
You
yep.
Like you do.
Beating drums from somewhere deeper beyond this temple get louder and louder and louder, and you begin to see shadows slither forth through...
Sorry.
Pull the rope up.
All right, no more colorful descriptions.
Yeah. Oh, no, I love it.
A bunch of lizard men attack you.
I love it. I'm scared. No, I was scared. I was really savoring it.
Thank you for his
juice.
No, it's pure juice. I crave that stuff.
You're not making it better.
You begin to see evil shadows on the walls as humanoid creatures begin to slither forth into the room. The drow says, hide.
Done.
They will think me.
Okay.
She says, they will think you fell into the acid and died.
Good point.
I think that she's, has good ideas that we should follow.
All right.
Let's get really far away from that acid.
So,
like, let's get.
You want to tuck in under like, his
sure,
left
that sounds
hawk,
great.
Right
let's
hawk.
Do that. Let's get away his from butt, there.
You're going to tuck yourselves under here?
Yeah.
Are you going to
And then I'm all like, and he's standing up.
Yeah, I fit under there snug.
Yeah.
All right. I'd like you both to make either dexterity checks or stealth checks if you're stealthy. Or move silently, or whatever.
Oops, whoops, whoops.
What?
Nine.
Nine.
Okay.
What's your plus?
One.
Ten.
Nine,
thirteen. No, sorry, right. 12. Math is hard.
I'm sorry about that.
AOFL, there are lots of shadows back here. You have no trouble blending in.
Yep.
Binwin has a bit more trouble. Mm. He just sort of rips a fart, and you're like...
I'm always nervous before a battle.
And suddenly coming out onto the balconies are lizard men.
What? Yeah! It's just like the cover of the Player's Handbook, guys.
Right.
I could hardly tell. All
right, I'm
and they
sorry,
come out
I'm
on both
excited.
Sides.
Look at them coming out.
I take this opportunity to mention to Omen just sort of offhandedly that this room only lasts for an hour.
Oh, your room you're up in.
Yeah, extra dimensional space.
Does it just blink and all your shit falls in?
Really? Just more keep coming out. Like, you guys are having a really happy talk about extra-dimensional space as literally every lizard man in the world is coming out onto here.
Whoa, what's this?
I have no idea.
Good catch.
Okay. It looked like one of the blink angels, and I was scared shitless.
Just don't blink. You'll be fine.
The lizardmen come out and they smell the acrid odor of the pit. They look down. They see it sort of bubbling and frothing. They see part of Omen's boot sort of disappear underneath.
And I got another pair.
They just sort of stare confused. But not for long, because then their big boss comes out and he's about 9.5 feet tall.
Oh.
Son of a bitch.
And he just leaps to here. What do you two do? Because he doesn't seem to be facing you. He seems to have leapt from the balcony onto the dais and is now peering down at the acid, looking for somebody to smash.
I think we should delay.
Higher!
I think we should delay. I really think we should delay.
Why? I think we should rush it.
Oh, that's a great idea.
I would like to...
Wait, but he's 9.5 feet tall and you're a dwarf. You're not strong.
You ever seen any of those...
And he starts looking around.
You want me to go toward the acid?
No.
You really want me to go toward... Okay, go,
I'm
do it. Fine, do it. Go, do
I'm
it.
I'm rushing
do it. Fine,
out.
Do it. It's fine, you do it.
He's
you
looking
it.
For some.
While he does that, I swear an oath of enmity
He sees elf-sized footprints eating away at the stone.
Oh...
He sees Aofel's footprints of acid on the
floor.
Go on
the now. Screen.
Well, I'd love to, but no one will shut the fuck up. Apparently, after 4 years, everybody's playing D&D tonight. All these guys. I'm going to rush and push his scaly ass in the acid.
All right.
And while he does that, I will swear an oath of enmity against him because it takes a full minute for me to do that now. It's one of the delightful features of D&D Next. D&D
is this a strength?
This is what we call a strength contest. It's your strength check against his.
But of course he gets an incredible advantage because the lizard man is completely oblivious.
All right, here we go. terrified.
Ah!
Damn, damn, damn!
Is this the good dam or the bad dam?
That's a good one.
23.
Whoa. Ooh.
You could say my hilarious catchphrase if you want to.
You shove his scaly ass into the pit. Would you like to roll 2d6
damage? 2d6
damage?
Sure, why not? I bought all these dice with sixes on them just for this. Why not leave them in the bag? Who cares? It's just for money.
What?
Six.
All right. He starts to flail away and scream.
Kill them all.
No problem. Plenty of acid for all of them.
Yep.
I don't know how we're going to help you with that.
You guys sort of peek down through your rope trick window. Yeah. You see this poor, unassuming giant lizard man flailing away, calling out to his children and wife. And
oh, Mary!
So he's from north of the wall.
Little Henry, no!
Wait, would it be funny if the lizard man goes, surprise, and it was a birthday party. Surprise, well, AFL. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. All right.
Well, it is AFL's 142nd birthday today.
Anyway.
I'm finally a man.
AFL, what would you like to do?
What do I see the lizard men doing?
They are gaping in horror.
Right? And the...
And they all sort of turn their eyes on Binwin at once.
Uh-huh.
Bring it.
I think that I'm going to go ahead and shoot one with my longbow.
All right.
So I will pick whichever one is the closest... most advantageous.
This one is the one of the closest ones. And
do I have a clear line of sight to
you
him?
You do.
Okay, then I'm just going to fire my longbow at him. Do I get any bonuses because I
am... So you're not going to keep swearing your oath? You're going to just put
hidden,
that on hold?
No, I think I'm going to cut it off and save it and hope that he flails around in the acid because I've been there, man. I've been there, and I know... that even if you roll 19, you can't get out of the acid.
All right, make your attack roll.
No.
Yeah. No, it's a 7. It's not a 1. I know, it looked like a 1 to me, too. So that's a 7, and do I get a dex bonus because it's a bow?
You got your
all right, so
modifier
10.
At the top there.
10, and then, sorry, my attack is 5, that's so 12.
12. All right, your 12 just hits him.
Oh, roll excellent. Damage. So I do D10 plus 3. 10 points.
All right, you kill him.
Bam!
Yeah, keep doing that.
I'm not useless! I'm not useless! I'm not useless!
First kill of the night. What?
First blood!
Yes.
That's right, first blood. That's a thing you say. Okay.
So I can look out of my hole. Can I see them?
Yeah, if you sort of hang down a little bit. Let it hang out a bit.
I say, just hold on to my cape, right? And I come out of the hole a little bit, and I'm gonna magic missile the closest one to me.
Okay. Roll your damage.
3.
All right. Your magic missile hits him in the chest, and he reels but holds his feet.
That's all I got, guys.
All right.
Pull me back up. Pull me back up.
Make a strength check, Omen.
Don't do it to him.
We're okay.
18. 18.
All right.
All right, how strong are you?
I'm not that strong.
Can you lift a tire over your head?
I cannot lift it, no.
Okay. You pull him up.
Okay.
A lot of lizards down there, man. A lot of lizards. I'm saying we chill here for about 45 minutes.
That's not
and
your
see
action,
plays
by the
out.
Way.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So in his exquisitely furnished bachelor pad, extra-dimensional bachelor pad, is there a table leg or a chair or something I can tie a rope to and tie myself to because I did not trust the wizard to hold me?
Yes. It's sculpted to look like Jim Darkmagic.
Of course it is.
If we get out of here, I really want to go see your secret.
It's really not. You should. I want everybody to come and see it.
How
long would it take to throw a quick loop around myself? I mean, is that my turn?
That's basically your action.
That's what's happening this turn.
All right.
Just as a heads up, that is an antique.
Okay. So I'll keep that in mind.
I just want you to be aware of that.
That got me.
That got you? That's a weird one. I don't know why that got you.
It is an antique.
Yeah, it is.
Scott, roll another d6 damage on that lizard guy.
2.
Okay. He starts to crawl his way out, dripping with acid.
Now it's an acid lizard,
fuck,
man.
Bullshit! Climbing out of the acid shit! I couldn't do that!
He's got, like, claws and alligator
Who's skin. Same team!
All right. Sorry.
The other lizard men are going to leap over here.
Shit. Are they not taking the stairs?
This guy will take the stairs. This guy will stay on the balcony.
Man. He yells at the other guys, it's really dangerous, guys.
No running around the pool.
These guys will stay there. All right, so a bunch of them leap out onto the dais. Two of them try to jump Binwin.
Yeah!
I rolled a 3 on the first attack.
That's not good.
And a 15 on the second
one. That's better.
How's your armor class there, Bin?
It's an 18. They're both pussies.
All right. Over your shoulder, you see the drow girl, Danielle, climb up to the shoulder of the demon statue and hide. Huh. And she pulls out one of her crossbows.
That's all, thank goodness. She has 2, don't forget.
Yes.
It's 2 per round. I'm just saying.
Their side. All right. And next up is you, Bin.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what you got to do. You know what you got to do.
Kick some
Wait
ass.
Wait a second. Your whole turn was tying a rope?
Yeah. It's a big, it's really thick.
What the hell kind of knot was this?
It's crazy shit.
I swing.
It's called a howler shank, a particular knot.
All right.
Yeah. Cut they him. Teach it in the Northlands.
He's looking out for your safety.
Is he?
Maybe.
Yeah, right?
I don't know.
Hit a guy!
All right. You guys were interrupting my attack, and then when I join in, you yell at me for nothing. I get it. All right, I'm going to swing my great axe, Seamus, at this guy.
All right.
Seamus? 15 plus 8.
Oh, yeah.
That's good.
Oh, yeah.
That's 23.
So,
Does Seamus have a song?
Fill me with blood. Nice.
Ooh.
So, 8 plus 4 points of damage.
12.
Oh, 12 you totally murder him.
Oh, really?
Yep, you crush
his lizard
skull.
Murderized him.
All right, well, I'm going to cleave then, because once per turn when I drop a creature to 0 hit points with a melee attack, I'll spend an experience die, so I can't use this right now, and I will make another melee attack against the next guy.
All right.
Nice.
Very nice.
Fill me with blood, I crave your blood. 15 plus 8.
Yep.
23.
If you didn't have the beer on, that would have rolled off the table.
I know.
Pulp them. Pulp.
10 points of damage.
You murder him.
All right.
Ah!
I could spend another experience dice to cleave through, but I don't think I'm close enough to Jebediah.
No, you're not quite.
Yeah, hang on to it for
my
deflection.
My thirst is quenched.
AFL.
Can I hit the big bad guy with fuck it, I might hit the dwarf. I'm gonna shoot my arrow at
That's my job. Big bad guy.
All right.
Don't worry about it.
20.
Yes.
All right.
Damn.
D10 plus 3. 8 plus 3 is 11
wow.
points.
All right, he nice reels roll. From that. Because he is perched on the edge of the acid pit, I'm going to make a dexterity saving throw.
This could be so
throw.
Poetic, you guys!
Oh!
That's a hell of a roll.
Yes. He rolled an 18. He hangs on.
He's Lizard of the Year.
He's got that
yeah,
tail.
19's not enough to crawl out, but 18's enough to hang on. Son of a bitch.
Life is so unfair.
At this point, you should just
unfair.
Learn from him. Like, don't kill him. Find out what he's doing
Interview
right.
Interview this lizard.
Yeah. These are skills that you need.
You need to be thinking about this shit long term.
You know, you guys have really great ideas for people who are safely tucked up inside Jim's little cozy fuck mansion in Dimension X.
Jim, you're up.
All right. I'm detecting a little bit of jealousy from AFL. Do you have a plan with this rope?
I just like ropes, I don't.
All right. Hold me, right? Hang on. Mm-hmm. And I lean out.
I always suspected.
Just hold me.
Omen's just using him for his money.
Yeah. And
he's
this,
a trophy
this,
wizard.
This cluster? Lizard over here, the one in the front there. No,
yeah.
No, the group of three of them.
Oh, yeah, yeah, right there.
Yeah, the guy up on the top mm-hmm. next to the brazier.
Justin Timberlake.
Brazier. I want to charm him.
Okay.
So, he's a humanoid, right?
Please tell me you drop down like Bugs Bunny when he dresses up like a girl and you're like,
no.
Yoo-hoo! Oh, lizard!
Oh, boy!
No, he drops down like a disco ball.
Yeah!
Yeah. And then the techno starts.
Yeah, you're the party
right.
starter.
Yeah.
Well, he's gonna have to make a saving throw.
Well, he's. I assume that he has less than 25.
He
hit
does.
Points. So it says if the target's hit point maximum is 25 or more, it makes a wisdom saving throw.
Well, that's very interesting.
Mm. Yeah, that sounds like a new rule, perhaps
no,
in D&D.
Yeah, he's. Yep.
All right. So that guy's on our side.
Oh,
well,
really?
He's on your side.
He's on my side.
He's not on their side.
Right. So that seems cool.
Yeah.
I got no idea how to get out of this hole, man.
He looks up at you and waves.
I point at his friends and I said, like, kill them.
His little lizard eyes turn into hearts, yeah. And they just have like, they've got, and in the hearts is Jim's face, just like that. And circling around his head are little magic Jim doves.
He may have a great idea to get us out of here.
That's exactly right.
Well, I mean, it makes a great sitcom, but I don't know how it helps.
Listen, there's not a lot I can do.
Wizard and Lizard, Fridays on the new CBS.
No, pretty good, actually.
This is CW, I think.
That's a
yeah.
CW?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
If it's on the CW, what time can be tonight on a very special Wizard and Lizard?
So actions work differently
Rudy
now.
Rudy the Undead
can
Hound
I come
has
out
a problem.
And do an action,
Lizard is pregnant.
My attack action,
yep.
And also shout something to Danielle.
You totally can.
Okay, I'm going to do
that.
But
first make a strength check.
But why would I do that? But obviously I'm bolstered by the rope.
Yes, you get a bonus.
Oh, fuck you. How big is that rope bonus? No, he took a whole turn to tie this knot.
That's 5.
Plus the bonus,
obviously.
Yeah, you get a plus 5 bonus, so
oh,
10.
10.
That's really, really good. Jim, you seem to slip and fall. But you can make a dex check because there's a rope hanging down here.
All right. Dex is +1.
Plus
this
one's,
can't go
plus
wrong.
One is really good.
17.
All right, now make a rope burn check.
That's not a check. That's not a check. That's not a check.
All right. So I'm dangling now.
Yeah,
right?
you're dangling.
I wave at my buddy.
Yeah.
Like, little help!
The lizardman waves back.
Yeah, okay.
I love you, Jim Darkmagic.
So I will say in D&D Next, there's only a couple spells that a wizard can take for a day. Mine aren't going to be super useful.
So, Omen, what else would you like to do?
Absolutely. Well, using the rope to assist me.
Yep.
I'm going to lean out and fire a blast of radiant light at John Lizardson right here.
Mm-hmm.
And that requires a roll.
Yes, it does.
So I'm going to do that, which is unfortunate, but here we go.
Oh! All
right. That's the 20. That's the highest one that's on.
Yep.
There.
Yep.
Nice job.
So how does a critical... Well,
hold on. We just want to enjoy this for a
moment.
Yeah,
let's save it.
Lady.
So, because it...
You finally made it.
Because it...
Welcome to the big time.
It feels good. It feels good. Thanks, Chris.
That was a great 142nd birthday present for me.
See, there you go. Now, how does a crit work in D&D Next?
Well, that's a very good question. So right now
we have no idea.
We don't know.
I know.
We haven't gotten to that part of the playtest.
We're going to playtest something new here for the first time.
Oh.
So you get to do maximum damage plus you get to do 2d6 extra damage plus an extra d6 when you're third level plus an extra d6 when you're fifth level. So you do a total of 4d6 on top of your max damage.
Wow. Oh my God.
So the crit climbs up.
Yep.
Okay. Well, that's 12 base.
Yep.
And we got 4d6 coming. 4d6. 12. 17.
Wow.
22.
Wow.
27.
Okay, that's not great.
28.
All right. The blinding...
Aren't you glad you waited?
I did. It feels good.
Yeah.
The blinding radiant light of your god burns a hole through his innards and lights him up like a jack-o'-lantern.
The flammable acid.
Burning him from the inside out and his...
Does he explode and cover Binman with chunks?
He does. He totally does. He blows to pieces, and you are covered with lizard snot.
It's all in your hair and on your glasses.
Yeah.
Oh. It's all in my face.
Yeah. That's right.
Your beard.
It's in my eye.
And then after he is obliterated,
yes.
I take a moment to say, Danielle, fix this fucking floor.
Oh, good call.
She says...
S'il vous plaît.